Web3. It sounds like one of those buzzwords, right? The kind tossed around by tech bros and crypto nerds at meetups. But here's the twist. You might have already dipped your toes into Web3 without even realizing it. Ever logged into a website using your crypto wallet instead of your email? That's Web3. Played a game where you actually own the digital items and can sell them if you fancy? Web3 again. Signed a document online or sent money without a middleman? Yep, that's Web3 too. Let us break it down. Web3 is basically using apps or services that connect directly to your wallet, not your email, your Facebook, or even your bank. It's like bringing your own passport and your own funds to the internet party. Think of the internet you use every day, Web2, as the cool kids call it. You create accounts with your email. You upload photos to Instagram, but Instagram owns them, not you. You buy games on Steam, but if Steam says goodbye, your game library goes with it. You're basically renting digital space from someone else. Now Web3 flips all that on its head. When you connect your wallet to an app, you're bringing your own identity, your own assets, your own proof that, hey, this is mine. Take OpenSea for example. People buy and sell NFTs straight from their wallets, no middleman. DeFi users swap tokens directly, skipping the banks and traditional exchanges. Gamers in Axie Infinity own their characters for real and can sell them to anyone, anytime. Even if you've never touched these platforms, the idea is spreading. Big names like Nike and Starbucks are offering digital collectibles that you own in your wallet. Musicians are selling songs straight to fans through blockchain platforms. It all comes down to one big difference: ownership versus access. In Web2, you're given access to use someone else's platform. In Web3, you own your digital assets and can take them wherever you go. Your wallet? Think of it as your universal login, your digital backpack. It holds your identity, your stuff, and your transaction history, all under your control. Now don't get us wrong. Web3 isn't replacing everything overnight. Most of us still use classic apps every single day. But Web3 tools are popping up more often, getting easier to use and sliding into our everyday lives. So if you thought Web3 was years away, have a peek at your apps. You might already be living in it. The internet's shifting, from platforms that own your data to networks where you own your assets. And that future? It's already knocking at your door. Join us and reach your next crypto level.